How can I become an extraordinary programmer? This is what every person who is trying to enter into the IT industry has a question about. So in this particular session, I'm going to share with you all the experience I have accumulated in last 16 years in IT education. I have seen different types of people, people who have come from computer science background, basically engineers, graduates, computer science engineers, non-computer science engineers. I have got an opportunity to train even biomedical science engineers. So all category of people I have seen, BCom graduates. And I have seen cases where in many circumstances, BCom graduates have performed better than even computer science graduates. I'm not saying computer science graduates are less. There are cases where certain people with completely non-technical background have really excelled well in the industry. Now, what exactly is the trick? What is the formula they have used to become an extraordinary programmer? I'm not talking about how to become a programmer. I'm talking about something very important. How to become an extraordinary programmer. There is a basic difference between programmer and extraordinary programmer. That piece of thing is what is going to be highlighted here. Extraordinary. Wonderful, awesome programmers. What is that which will make you stand out from others? So all these tips, I would suggest you to listen to it very carefully. And not just listen, also implement it, as I'm going to end up with showing you practical steps on how to improve programming skills. And these things you'll have to implement using system. Now, let us begin with a simple question. What is an application? An application is a ready-made program which is going to perform a particular task as per the requirement of a user on an operating system. See, operating system controls the hardware. So there needs to be now something which has to give instruction to the hardware through operating system. And that is where the applications are going to come into picture. So Notepad is an application basically used for managing text. WordPad is an application for managing text with more formatting facilities. Paintbrush is an application for drawing. PowerPoint is an application for presentation. Excel is an application for managing your sheets, accounts sheets, tables, graphs, and so on. So like this, there are different applications which are used by different types of people in the industry for performing different types of tasks. So basically, an application is, can I say, giving instruction to the operating system on behalf of the user? Precisely, yes. So an application is made up of instructions and the data which is going to flow through these instructions. I repeat, an application is a collection of related instructions and the data which is going to flow through these instructions. So now, what is that a programmer's role is in developing an application? Yes, it is the programmer who is responsible for developing the application. Programmers write instructions which are part of applications. Programmer write instructions connecting one instruction to the other instruction, letting the data to flow through those instructions in a meaningful manner. Basically, programmer is the one which makes the connect between different instructions, letting the data pass from one instruction to the other instruction, and based on certain predefined input, get some predefined output. Basically, an application in computer is never going to ever perform a task which otherwise a human being cannot perform. Only what as a human being I can perform a normal task manually, the same thing application is going to perform through a system. This is very clear to all of us. Then what is the role of a programmer? Yes, programmer is the one who will develop the application. So if I am a programmer, I am going to write instructions and develop the application. Then what is the role of programming language? See, if I want to perform any task, first, most important point is I should know how should I do that task. For example, I want to add two numbers. I should know how to add two numbers manually. Only if I know how to add those two numbers manually, I can add them. So first, I should know how to do. Second, I should be able to do it. Third, only when I know how to do it and I am able to do it, I will be able to communicate to somebody on how to do it. Let us say I have to teach you to perform a particular household task. But unless I know that the task can be done, and unless I have already done that task myself, I cannot be a good instructor in teaching somebody how to perform that particular task. Then comes the very important role. Only when I can communicate properly to somebody what the task has to be performed, the other person will understand properly and they will execute exactly in the same way as I want it to be done. It should not happen like I am trying to explain to somebody an apple through my words, but in the process of explaining, they are trying to construct an orange out of it. The description I give for apple should be in such a way that I properly understand apple first, I should have tasted the apple first, and then when I am explaining apple, the other person should also in its imagination construct an apple only. Unless the other person also constructs apple, the communication is not happening properly. So this is very important. I repeat the whole thing. If I want to perform a task of an application, the first thing I should know is how to perform the task. Then I should have performed the task myself manually. Third, I should be in position to now explain to somebody how the task should be performed. Only when I am able to do these three things, now we can think about writing an application and performing the same task using a computer. Now the other person has to be replaced with a computer as the machine, and the communication language which we used with the other person earlier now has to be a programming language for making communication with the computer. So computer does not understand languages like English, Hindi, Telugu, Malayalam, or it can be French, Japanese, Chinese. They don't understand these languages. Computer understands programming language. So we have to now learn a programming language, maybe something like C, C++, C Sharp, Java, any one language which is of our choice, which we are going to become conversant with, and start giving instructions to the computer. So does computer actually understand my programming language? Fairly speaking, no. Our programming language what we use is actually considered to be a source code high level language for computer. There will be language compilers in the computer which will be responsible for converting the code from high level language to machine level language, and machine level language is what a computer understands. But as a programmer, we need not worry about machine level language. Our job is very simple. We write programs using high level languages like C, C++, and compilers are there which are responsible for converting those high level languages into machine level languages. So one thing is very clear, to become a good application programmer, you need to have a very, very, very strong command on the programming language. For example, if I have to talk to you, if I do not have a good command on English language, I will only do blah, 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 and there will be no meaning to any kind of sentence which I am going to communicate with you. Similarly, here the other party is a computer. So unless I have a command over the programming language. I cannot write statements. I cannot link instructions. I cannot build application, and the applications cannot execute. So the conclusion is, to become an application developer, you need to have knowledge of programming language. Now, when I say programming language, what is that you should learn? Every language, whether it is human spoken language or programming languages, have two things. One is the grammar and the other is the dictionary. When I say grammar, I mean also includes alphabets, it includes word formation, it includes all the appropriate grammar stuff. In concept of programming language, yes, the grammar is nothing but the syntax of the language. You should be very good at syntax of the language. Only then you have command over the language. Basically, when I say syntax, what do I mean? I mean, we should know how to declare variables. We should know how to declare data types, how to do casting, what are operators, what are the different types of statements, all these things, how to declare arrays, how to call methods, all these things are what one is supposed to have very good knowledge of. Only then they can claim they know good grammar. Now, the second point is, suppose I have to learn English. Is it okay if I learn A to Z? Is it okay if I learn just the grammar, A, E, I, O, U, how to use is, the, an, what are noun, pronoun, verb? If I know all these things, is it sufficient? Absolutely not. To improve upon our English as a communication, we have to learn more and more words in the dictionary. Because unless we know the meaning of words in the dictionary, we cannot use them in phrasing sentences. And unless we know how to phrase sentences, we cannot write paragraphs or we cannot speak at a stretch. So yes, likewise, every programming language is going to provide us with certain API, application programming interface we call it. So we are supposed to have knowledge of language syntax and language API both. Syntax part will comparatively take less time, but to learn language API, it is going to take lots of time. Rather, it's almost never ending process. It's a continuous never ending process. The more you learn the API, the better. It's like the more words you learn in the dictionary, the better command you will get over the language. Like that, the more API you keep learning, the better command you are going to get on the programming language. So to develop application as a programmer, we need now two things. One, you have to build syntax of the language. Two, you have to build the API of the language. Only when you are having very good command on these two, you are ready to start developing applications. Till that time, you're not ready for developing applications. Now, the most important question which people ask: what is logic? How can I improve it? I have seen people even coming and telling me, I'm very poor in logic. Now, what exactly does this sentence mean? I'm poor in logic. Now, logic is what? If you know 2 plus 2 is 4, don't you think it is correct? If you know taking a leg forward and then the next leg forward, you are going to move in the forward direction. You will not go in backward direction. If you know this, you are correct or wrong? Now, only if I tell some sentence which is meaningless. For example, I stand in center of the street and I then say, I am the prime minister of this country. My people, please listen. Is there any logic in that? No. What should happen to these kind of people? Yes, these kind of people should be put up in mental hospital. Basically, every human being who is normal has logic. People who do not have logic are called as mental. They are psychologically weak people. They should be in mental hospital. So you and I have good logic that is confirmed. Then why this statement comes, my logic is poor? Actually, the interpretation is wrong. When you say my logic is poor, what is actually poor is the ability of a person to convert the logic which he has in doing something manually into a programming language and performing the same task through a computer. I repeat, what probably we have to improve upon is not the logic. We have to improve upon the ability of a person. Let us say, I have to improve upon my ability to program a given requirement as per a logic which I would use for performing the task manually. But now I want to do that task through a computer. So basically I have logic, but the logic has to be given the shape of programming language, and that is what we have to improve upon. So when can that happen? Logic is already there. Programming language is the only thing which can be the weakness. Yes. So if one has to really improve ability to develop application, don't work on your logic, work on your programming skills, improve your grammar, improve your knowledge of the API, and then automatically you will have the ability to write the logic through code and give instructions to the computer. I think this is very simple point. Never after today I would expect one to tell my logic is poor. Your logic is poor, then you should go to the hospital. What is poor? My ability to convert a logic which I have into a language of computer. That we will develop by improving programming language skill set. So that is very important point which one should know. Now the question is, what is that a fresher should do as a programmer and a fresher should not do as a programmer? Very, very important. I as a programmer, problem is I already know certain applications which are existing in the world. Now I really somehow is a person who would like the methodology in which we were trained in the schools from the kindergarten right from the beginning. I somehow like that methodology perfectly. See, when I was sent to the school for the first day, there was nothing in my mind except for crying. I just cried because it was a new environment to me. I was not used to that environment. I cried, and whole day what probably went into is crying and came back. Maybe 2 days, 3 days, it might have happened like that. Only after some time I got acquainted to the teacher, to the environment, and then they started telling me what is A, what is B, what is C. Over a period of time, I learned A, B, C, D and so on up to Z, let us say. The good thing is at that point of time when teacher was telling me to learn A, I did not even know that tomorrow she is going to tell me B. And when she was telling me B, I did not even know day after she is going to teach me something like A for apple. Or when I was learning A for apple, I did not know she would tell me apple a day keeps the doctor away. I did not know that. And when she was telling me that, I did not know that using sentences, I would be able to someday now write stories and talk continuously for hours together. So basically, we never had knowledge of what we are going to do in the future when we were learning the language English. And it just gradually happened that with that as the foundation, when I started my career with A, B, C, today I am able to write complete paragraph, large stories. So there is a gradual process of development which happened. But unfortunately, the problem we have with the fresh programmer today is many of us have already seen programs. Many of us have already seen applications. So we know these applications are possible and we directly aim to write those applications rather than following a step-by-step learning curve. And that's where the blunder happens. That's where you feel somehow inferiority complex and not able to immediately program large applications. I would say, why do you worry about it today? When you're beginning your career at this point of time, there is absolutely no need to think of writing large applications in tomorrow's date or day after date or 1 month later. We will, no doubt about it. We will be able to write large applications, complex applications. We will be able to convert the requirement of our client into the software programs. Applications will be developed. Absolutely, that is the target. But I am saying, do not worry about them. when you are beginning as a fresh programmer. So what to start with? Concentrate on initially syntax of the language, not even the API. Just concentrate on syntax of the language. Learn what is syntax for declaration of variable. Learn what is syntax for initialization of variable. Learn how to write for loop, how to write while loop, how to write if condition, how to write switch statement, how to use operators, what are the different types of expression. Learn syntax of the language thoroughly. Try to avoid missing even a single character in the language. Know all the rules, all the things which you are supposed to know as the syntax by heart, mug up. Just imagine, you know A to Z, but you don't know one character in between. Any one character. Let's say you don't know S. Now, if you don't know S, how will you spell so many words where S will come into picture? Fresh, F-R-E-S-H, fresh, it will become fresh. So we are not communicating properly. Just one character out of 26 characters you drop and your whole communication will become meaningless. Likewise, I am suggesting here, you have a very strong command on the language. Syntax of the language should not be your weakness at any point of time. Then only you should start thinking of writing programs. Until you have very strong syntax, do not start writing programs. That is very, very, very important. So what you should do? First, you should know that you are just a beginner. You should not think of writing large applications in the initial stage. You will eventually become programmer. That is, of course, the goal. Right now, develop the knowledge of syntax. That is what is going to be your first step. And precisely, that is what we have done in all our videos till now. All the language basics of C# which we learned was purely dedicated to only teaching you syntax of the language and all aspects what a programmer is supposed to know. But now that we have already learned the syntax of the language, what should be my practical next step to improve my programming skills? Now comes the main point. Now what I suggest is, see, to write a story, again go back, to write a story, I should first know how to read a story. That is not sufficient. When I read the story, I should understand the meaning of the story. That is also important. But to read the story, we should learn the English as a language. Precisely, now that we have completed syntax of the language, we have the ability to now see the program and understand the programming constructs. The immediate next thing we'll have to do now is understand the connect between different statements. So how are we going to do this? So to do this, what I suggest is, I have provided here a list of programs. A lot of programs are given to you. So I'm doing for few, you should do for the rest. Start studio. Create a new project. Say console application. Samples. Demo app. Some name you give to the project. Click on OK. This creates a skeleton code. If you want, you can keep it as it is. But most of it, we know we don't need it. So we can delete it. We can even remove the namespace, actually not required. So basic skeleton is ready. Now what you do is, from this series, you see a lot of methods available here. All these are methods available. I suggest you to copy the implementation of this method and paste it inside main. Now spend a while in trying to understand the syntax of it. Okay, this is declaration of integer. Here I am writing a message on the console window. Then I'm reading a number, good enough. Then if n mod 2, okay, modulus operator, if it is equal to 0, that means if n mod 2, if a number divided by 0, if the remainder is 0, divided by 2, if the remainder is 0, it's an even number, else it is an odd number. So now looking at this, you have concluded, okay, this is the program which is going to provide me for a given input on keyboard, whether it is an even number or odd number. Fine. Now what is the next step? Next step is use start without debugging. Run the program as it is run. Enter an integer. Okay, so enter the integer 2, even number. Good. Now press something like 3, odd number. Good. Okay, now we understood this. Your immediate action should not be close the program. No, don't do that. Now that you have seen the program, you have predicted the output, you got the output also, now trace it. Now start using F11 and click on this step into, enter a number 2, enter, step into. Basically, I am asking you to now trace the code. Trace the code not once, trace the same piece of code for different sets of input. Trace it for 2, trace it for 10, trace it for 15, trace it for 20, trace it. I am telling you to get used to connecting the statements one after the other. And that will happen not by pressing Control F5 and direct execution, but with the ability to trace the code using F11 as the shortcut. So that is something very important. Now that you have done this program, the immediate next thing which I want you to do is comment the code. Code is there. I have not commented for you. You should comment it. So what is that you will do now? Here you will write. Now read the value from console. Then here you should write. Check if the remainder is 0 or not. And write here. If remainder is 0, then the number is even number. And then if remainder is not 0, then the number is odd number. Just do this, comment it. This task is over. Finish, erase it off. Now go to next program. Copy the next program. Let's say I copy this now. I copy all this. Paste it. Replace it now. Finish. That task is over. If you want, you can save it. Now paste here. Now do the same exercise once again. Okay, there are 5 variables declared. Then we are entering the 2 integer. We are reading the first number. We are reading the second number. Adding the first number and second number. And subtracting, multiplying, dividing. Okay, some float is being used. Y typecasting is done. Blah, 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 blah. Now again press Control F5. Enter the 2 numbers. Okay. Okay. Achha. That is fine. Okay. Now what is the next step? Trace it. Debug. Start debugging. Trace it. Now as you are tracing, maybe you would want to pin certain variables. Pin it. All these variables you can pin it. Now what is important is, we take it for granted that we understood the program and we do not go through this particular learning process. In the process, the basic problem is we will never develop this skill set to connect one statement with the other statement. And that is where people do not become strong in programming. We will write statements, but unless you connect it, it cannot become application. You have to connect it. And that is what you should do here. And once you are done with this exercise of tracing it, again you will comment all the code here, and that comment you should be able to understand. Done. Go to next. Like this, I am giving you here a list of almost around 30 programs for you to practice, and it's my challenge. Once you have gone through this exercise, understood all these programs, I'm not saying all 30 you would be able to practice, but I would suggest, based on the time which is available to you, as much time as you can practice, as many programs as you can practice in the same exercise. I know it will become routine, mundane, but it's okay. Just continue doing the same thing again and again, again and again, again and again. A stage will come where you'll get polished, you'll get shined. You're getting clean now. You will start shining after some time, and that will become your attitude whenever you write a program. And you see, the way these programs are given is, as you are going down, the programs are getting complex and complex. More and more complex they are becoming. And they are becoming larger and larger. So the more deeper you go into this exercise, the better skill set on programming you are going to develop. That is the assurance. I would suggest take out some time and do all these programs of C#. And by the time you end this particular chapter, I am 100% confident you will have extraordinary capabilities on programming skill set. I'm not saying you can still develop programs on your own. That is going to take time. That's a time consuming process. You might take a month also to develop, to write programs completely independent of everybody else on your own. But right now we are able to connect, we are able to understand, and we are able to proceed. That is what you have to do all this exercise. Maybe it will take 2 days, maybe it will take 3 days. I would suggest you to continue. But this doesn't end. This is one exercise. So in this process, what you are doing, you are seeing, you are understanding, you are replicating. You are seeing, you are understanding, you are replicating, you are commenting. That's all. Once you are done through this exercise, the next thing I would want you to do is, I'm giving you another set of examples. These are all in VB. These are all sample programs in VB. Now, what will you do now? Copy this program. Paste it now in C# editor. A VB program is copied and pasted in C# editor. I know you may not know VB, but the task is, you know corresponding things in C#. Now convert it. C# is case sensitive. P. Class. C is lowercase. This is class name. Keep it as it is. Semicolon. Then floor brackets. Followed by that P. Shared. In C# we know main is supposed to be static. So shared gets replaced with static. Sub is basically like void. Return type void. Main. And then go down. Console.WriteLine integer. In C#, what is integer? Yes, we know it is int. Dot max value semicolon. Int dot max value semicolon. Double in C# is double. D lowercase. So D lowercase and semicolon. And semicolon. This main ends here, and then this class ends here. This is complete C# program. Now run Control F5. We get the output. Okay, this is a maximum, minimum, minimum, maximum. Fine. What we did? We are looking at a language which we don't know and converting this to a language which we know. So in the process, you'll have to strain your brain to find out equivalence of these things in C#. You'll have to put some energy. Maybe you'll have to go back to your C# handouts. Maybe you'll have to see what all is there in that. And this is what you are going to do for all the programs which are given in this particular handout. One by one, all these programs you are going to convert from VB.NET to C#. And by the time you develop this, now you are extraordinary programmer of language C#. You will see that there is a very high level of confidence in you, and you will be able to understand any kind of program which is already existing, and you're not too far away from the ability to program individually. But of course, for that we need to learn API, and that part we haven't covered yet. I wish you a very, very, very successful programming career ahead. Thank you.